Welcome to our virtual dive on the Japanese submarine I-124. If watching online, make sure to set your playback resolution as high as possible. The best way to watch is with a VR headset. You can also use your phone or tablet to look around. You can also watch on a computer screen by using your mouse to look around. The Imperial Japanese Navy submarine I-124 was sunk outside Darwin Harbour after an engagement with the Australian corvette HMAS Deloraine on the 20th of January 1942. This virtual dive has been created to mark the 80th anniversary of the sinking of one of Australia's most significant World War II wrecks. A new high-resolution sonar survey of the submarine wreck was carried out in October 2021 by the Australian Institute of Marine Science for their research vessel, Solander. The surveyors used a technique called multibeam to undertake the most detailed survey ever carried out on this submarine. It shows that the wreck remains largely intact, and recognisable features include the conning tower in the centre of the wreck and the gun. At this stage, a number of physical features can be identified. There appears to be holes along the deck and damage to the conning tower. Are these changes associated with the battle in 1942, the sinking event, or are they associated with corrosion and other natural processes after lying on the seabed for decades? Archaeologists drawn ship plans and historic photographs to better interpret what they see and to help build a realistic and detailed model of the wreck. The construction plans show that the submarine had an inner and outer hull, and only the inner cylinder was watertight. The submarine was built and launched in 1927. The Imperial Japanese Navy based the design on the German U-2 class of mine-laying submarines built during World War I. On the 20th of January 1942, the I-124 sighted the HMAS Deloraine, part of Darwin's naval defence. It launched a torpedo which passed just 3 metres from the Deloraine's stern. The Deloraine, supported by other naval ships and aircraft, soon converged on the scene, and its crew deployed an early version of sonar to find the sub and attack it with depth charges. Having exposed their location, the Japanese crew attempted to evade attack. After being forced to the surface briefly, the I-124 was unable to withstand this barrage and made a final descent to the seabed, 46 metres below, where it remains to this day. The I-124 was laying mines and hunting Allied ships outside Darwin Harbour when it was sunk. But now, decades later, we can reflect and recognise the submarine as the final resting place of Captain Kishigami and his crew of 80. The I-124 was the first wreck in Australia to be protected under Commonwealth legislation. This site remains protected under the Underwater Cultural Heritage Act. Recreational diving is currently not permitted. The I-124 is not an easy dive. It is deep. There is very poor visibility and strong tides. Nevertheless, the NT Heritage Branch is planning a technical dive to conduct an in-depth visual and photographic survey. Digital reconstructions like this, using remote sensing data and historical evidence, help archaeologists both to understand wrecks as archaeological sites and also better manage them as part of our maritime heritage.